Hi, welcome to Erratic Solutions. It continue this timers concept. In previous session, we discussed about the timers calculations and what are the initial values and how timers functioning and what way your timers are allowing to calculate the pulses. Okay, so based on the capacity of timer, your 8051 is supporting two 16-bit timers, which are T0 and T1. So this timer is capable of counting pulses from 0 to 65,535 because these two are two 16-bit timers. So whenever the timer capacity is 16-bit, it can count 2 power 16 pulses for one rotation. Okay, so based on this, you need to know what is the duration I am waiting for each count. That is depends on pulse period. The pulse period formula is very clear, which is 12 divided by crystal frequency. So as per our microcontroller working, so we are just dealing with 11.0592 megahertz. So I am getting 1.0852 microsecond. So this is the time duration I am getting between each count. The exact time delay is 1.0852 microsecond. So this I am deciding based on the pulse period. The second formula is number of pulses. So number of pulses formula is very clear, which is required time delay divided by pulse period. So whatever the time you are looking, maybe which is in milliseconds or microseconds, so based on this you need to calculate number of pulses. So as per this I am getting some. So 500 into 1000 microseconds divided by 1.0852 microseconds. So I got here, which is around 460,745 pulses. So this I am doing, I need to count these 460,745 pulses. But you have to start your timer with some initial value. So you are already aware, whenever you begin with zero, you cannot stop timer at any middle point by reaching maximum value. Maximum value is 65,535 here. So just by reaching maximum value only, you can stop timer by using the flag bits. So this you will get in programming. But the working process is very clear. Whenever timer begins with some initial value. Okay, as a programmer, you can set this initial value. It may be 0 or it may be some other value. But the possibility is here, you can stop just timer by reaching only maximum value. So there is no chance to stop timer at any middle point. That is the reason, as a programmer, you should be very clear on this initial value. So for this 460,745 pulses, I am counting 57,593 pulses 8 times. So or else you can divide this 460,745 with 8, you will get 57,593. So this counting value is always less than 65,535. That is the only reason I am taking this counting value which is less than 65,535. Because your timer is not count more than 65,535. Again, it is overwrites with a 0. Once it will reach maximum value, it overwrites with a 0. So that is the reason I need to go for this calculation. Whenever you are looking for these 57,583 pulses, my initial value is 7942 and counting up to 65,535, and so that I am able to count 57,583 pulses. This process I am repeating 8 times. So this 7942 is my initial value now. Okay, so this is the calculation part behind this timers. So this is how for every time delay you should be very clear on pulse period, number of pulses and initial value. Now proceeding with programming. Whenever you are looking to program these timers for applications, so you need to know about the standard SFRs related to these timers, which are TMOD and TCON. So these two SFRs, T you should understand clearly whenever you are attempting program timers. The first register TMOD, which is helping us to select the timer in different modes. The name itself, TMOD, stands for timer mode register. Your timers are working in different modes, so how to select that particular mode by using this TMOD register individual bits. Whereas TCON, which is helping us to control the timers. So control means if you are looking to start the timer or stop the timer, and whether timer reaches its maximum value or not, this is all monitored by TCON resistor bits. So these two SFRs are very important, you need to understand while doing timers program. See the first register TMOD. It is an 8-bit register, and this is one special function register which is helping us to select the timer in modes, in different modes. But this register is not bit addressable, so you need to understand clearly the differences between bit addressable register and not bit addressable register. Whereas TMOD is not bit addressable register, so that it doesn't allow to access individual bits from this register. If you are trying to change any logic of this particular bit from your TMOD register, you need to change the complete register value. So there are 8 individual bits from TMOD. So this is LSB D0 and D7 is your MSB bit. And coming to the individual bits of TMOD, the first bit is gate, and second one is counter slash timer, and M1, M0. And again, same repeated bits here, gate, counter slash timer, M1, M0. So they are giving some repeated bits here, but the working of these 8 individual bits is separated. The 4 LSB bits used to access timer 0 or counter 0. And next 4 bits, MSB part used for timer 1 or counter 1. So this is how you should know clearly the LSB part of TMOD register is helping us to select the timer 0 or counter 0, and MSB part of TMOD register is helping us to select timer 1 or counter 1. And by default, all bits logics are zeros. So default hexadecimal value of TMOD register is 00H, because the value of TMOD register is affect timer or counter in which operating mode. So according to this 8 individual bits, you should understand what is gate by keeping logic 0, what is the reaction of timers by making logic 1, what are the changes with timers or counters. So if you are selecting or if you are making gate bit logic 0, then timers or counters are selected in software control mode. Means, so without doing any hardware pulses, which means without giving any external pulses, your timers or counters starts counting process. So but keeping logic 1 for this gate bit, so the timers or counters under hardware control. So what is meant by hardware control here? So hardware control means the timers are going to start the counting process based on external pulse. So whenever you are taking this 8-bit logic 1, the timer's behavior is going to change. So generally, if you begin with timer's counting process, it maybe starts with some initial value. You have started counting process from 7942 to 65535. It will run as usual by making gate bit logic 0. But if you are making gate bit logic 1, even though you are starting your counter, it doesn't start counting process. So it requires external pulse. like the difference between regular clock and stopwatch. Your regular clock, which is running without any hardware inputs from outside, once you power on that, it runs normally. It's keep on counting seconds and which is showing your minutes, hours, everything. But whereas stopwatch is also used to measure minutes, seconds, hours. But if you want to start the functioning of stopwatch, you need to operate the button from outside. So that button means you are giving some input to the device, then only it starts counting process. The same thing, your timers are looking for external pulse if they want to start this counting process. And where I need to provide this external pulse, there are respective pins from the microcontroller. If you want to start timer 1 counting process, it requires external pulse across INT1 pin. So this external pulse may be from switch or from sensor or from anything. It requires one external high to low pulse across INT1 pin if you are dealing with timer 1 gate bit. The same way, if you are looking to deal with timer 0 gate bit, then you need to provide external pulse across INT0. So this is the one difference by making gate bit logic 0, gate bit logic 1. If gate bit logic is 0, timers are not depending on external pulse, they will run normally. But by making gate bit logic 1, you need to provide external pulse to start this counting process along with start bit or stop bit from TCON resistor. But remember, most of the cases, if you are using timers, you will proceed with gate bit logic 0. Okay, so because delays are two types. So if you want to do any operation automatically, like I am looking to turn on my load for every 5 minutes on, 5 minutes off. If you keep gate bit logic 0, then the 5 minutes counting process which will run normally. But other aspect is, like whenever I am coming to the office and it has to run 5 minutes and it has to go turn off after 5 minutes automatically, then that taking external pulse or external input to the system, that depends on your sensor or any external source you can take it. But always timers are depending on external pulse by making gate bit logic 1. This is one difference for gate bit 0 and 1. The second bit is counter slash timer bit. So this bit logic decides whether you are choosing timer or counter. If this bit logic is 0, you are selecting timer 1. If this bit logic is 1, you are selecting counter 1. So this is for this C slash timer bit. So this bit logic is always used to select the timer or counter. So C slash timer or T bar bit decides 0 timer and 1 counter. The next two bits, M1, M0. So these two use it to choose the mode of timers. So these two bits together will decide the modes of timers. 0-0 combination, your timer selected in mode 0. So here, the different modes of timers will reduce the capacity of timer. In general, the timer's capacity is 16 bit, which is the maximum. But as a programmer, you can change the capacity of timer by choosing in different modes. Whereas mode 0, the timer capacity is 13 bit. So you need to understand for 13 bit how many pulses it can count for one cycle. Okay, so whenever you are choosing timer in 13 bit, the capacity of timer will become 2 power 13. So 2 power 13 equivalent value is 8192. So in this case, the timer is capable of counting only 8192 pulses by selecting mode 0. So, which means if you begin with 0, what is the maximum count? 8191. In this case, not 65,535. So, if you are selecting in mode 0, the timer is capable of counting only 8192 pulses for one rotation. So, your calculation which is going to change according to the mode, because you are not dealing with 65,535 now as per mode 0. Suppose you are just making these two bits as 0-1 logics. Then your timer selected in mode 1, In this case, your timer capacity is 16 bit. This is the default case or default capacity. The default capacity of timer is 16 bit as always, but you need to select in mode 1. So that combination is M1 logic is 0 and M0 logic is 1. Suppose 10 logic, which is decides mode 2. So in this case, the timer capacity is 8 bit. So again, you need to understand for 8 bit, how many pulses it can count for one rotation, 0 to 255, because 2 power 8 is 256. So it depends on this mode selection, your timer's capacities are going to change. Whereas 1-1 combination, this is mode 3, in this case, which is timers are used as split timer mode. So split timer is not used for delay generations most of the cases, because your timer is divided into two parts. The higher part will work for counter and lower part used for timer. So this split timer is not preferred for delay generations. You are going to use above three modes for delay generations most of the cases. So the same description you need to apply for timer 0 bits also. So timer 0 gate bit, if it is 0, your timer 0 starts counting process normally. If you are making timer 0 gate bit logic 1, then it expects external pulse across INT 0 pin. Then counter slash timer bit depends on the logic of this C slash timer bit. You need to decide whether counter 0 is selected or timer 0 is selected. And M1, M0 decides the capacity of timer 0. Whether you are choosing in 13 bit mode, or you are selecting in 16 bit, or you are just choosing 8 bit mode or split time. That depends on your requirement. If you are looking for more cycles count, you need to go with mode 1 default most of the cases. But the value or logics you need to set for TMOD resistor. For TMOD resistor, it is not possible to access individual bits because it is not bit addressable. That you need to remember. You need to affect the total entire resistor value in programs. So I'll give the table to select your timers or counters in different modes as per this. So you need to understand how I got this hexadecimal value of TMOD resistor. That depends on mode and timer or counter. So I'll just write modes in columns. Mode 0, mode 1, mode 2, and mode 3. And looking for timer 0, what is your hexadecimal value of TMOD resistor? If suppose I am looking for counter 0, what are the values? Looking for timer 1, what are the values? And counter 1, what are the values? So these hexadecimal values you can use for programs. Looking for timer 0, mode 0. So whenever I am looking for timer 0, mode 0, just deal with these 4 LSB bits of TMOD resistor. I will remove the default logics so that it is easy to understand. If I am dealing with only timer 0, mode 0, this default bits logics are not changing, then think about the LSB part of TMOD resistor, because I am looking for timer 0, mode 0. So in general, gate bit logic is 0, because most of the cases delay generations are happens in software control. And C slash timer bit, so this is timer or counter you are looking, so timer, so that this logic is 0. Mode 0 means these two bits are 0 zeros. So finally, the hexadecimal value for this is 00H. So timer 0, mode 0, hexadecimal value is 00H, which means in program, if you are assigning TMOD resistor value as 00, then you need to understand you just selected timer 0 mode 0. Then what about timer 0 mode 1? So again, gate is 0 and looking for timer. Mode 1 means these two bits are 0 1. 0 0 0 1. So this equivalent is 0 1 H. And timer 0 mode 2. Mode 2 means only these two bits logics are going to change as 0 0 1 0, which is 2. 0 2 H. And timer 0 mode 3. So mode 3 means the mode selection bits logics are 1 1 combination. So this is 0 3 H. Then I am looking for counter now. Counter 0 mode 0. So counter 0 means you need to change this C slash timer bit logic. Looking for counter so that C slash timer bit logic is 1, and mode 0 means these two bits are 0 0. 0 1 double 0 equivalent is 4, which is 0 4 H. And mode 1 means M1 M0 bits are going to change as 0 1. 0 1 0 1, which is equivalent is 5. And mode 2 means 1 0. 0 double 1 0, which is 6. 7. This is mode 3. So this is how you need to fix the values of TMOD hexa values in programs. As per this, you need to decide which timer or which counter you are looking in applications. Suppose I am looking for timer 1. So don't disturb the 4 LSB bits from TMOD register and change your logics according to your requirement. Again, looking for timer 1 mode 0. So anyway, gate bit logic is 0. Looking for timer, so this bit logic is 0. Mode 0 means 0 0. So the final hexadecimal value is 0 0 H. And next, looking for timer 1 mode 1. So mode 1 means M1 M0 bits logic says 0 1. So hexadecimal value is 1 0 H. Next, M1 M0 as 1 0. This is 2 0 H. And mode 3 means 1 1. So this is 3 0 H. And next, looking for counter 1. So counter 1 means C slash timer bit becomes 1, and mode 0 means 0 0. So final hexadecimal value is 4 4 0 H. Just 5 0 H, 6 0 H, 7 0 H. So this is the table. It helps you to select the timer or counter in different modes in programs. So finally, your TMOD register is helping us to choose the timer or counter in different operating modes. So this is how your TMOD register is helping us to select the timer or counter in modes. The second register, I'll brief again. The first TMOD register is at 8 individual bits, and first bit is helping us to select the timer or counter in which control. Software control or hardware control. Software control means without any external input, it starts counting process. And hardware control means it compulsory expects external pulse across the respective pins INT0 and INT1. If you are using timer 1, provide your external pulse across INT1. If you are dealing with timer 0, provide your external pulse across INT0 by making gate bit logic 1. Then the second bit, counter slash timer, is helping us to select timer or counter. 0 logic timer, 1 logic counter. And M1 M0 mode selection bits or changing the capacity of timers according to the logics. 0 0 logic 13 bit capacity, 0 1 logic 16 bit capacity, 1 0 logic 8 bit capacity, 1 1 logic, which is split timer into two parts. The second SFR register, which is TCON now. this is your second SFR register, which is TCON. The TCON stands for timer control register. But this register is bit addressable compared to your TMON. So bit addressable means you need to understand the bit register allows to access individual bits in programs. Okay. So let's see the 8 bits of TCON. Is D0 to D7 and 8 individual bits are TF1, TR1, TF0, TR0, IE1, IT1, IE0, IE0. So these are 8 individual bits from TCON register. So these 8 bits default logics are zeros. So default hexadecimal value is 00H. This is your TCON register default values. So among these 8 individual bits, the first 4 bits, which is LSB part, which is helps to control interrupts, whereas the MSB part of TCON register is deals with timers control. So these 4 bits you need to use for timers programming, these 4 bits you need to use for interrupts programming. Anyway, this register is bit addressable, you need to access the individual bits of TCON register. But let's see the importance of 8 bits from TCON. The first bit is TF1, which is timer 1 flag bit. So this flag bit logic is 0 default, but the logic of TF1, which is changing according to the timer's running process. Okay, so you are not going to set a clear by the programmer, this automatically set a clear according to the timer behavior. So this will 0 default state, and TF1 is becoming 1 whenever timer reaches maximum value. So maximum value, which is not fixed always, depends on mode, which is changing, because your TMOD is going to change the capacity of timer. If it is a 13 bit mode, your maximum value is 8191. If it is a 16 bit mode, the maximum value is 65535. If it is an 8 bit mode, maximum value is 255. So that you need to understand the importance of flag bit here. If it is logic, the logic of TF1, which is changing according to the timer's running process. If you begin with any initial value, not zero, so if you are putting any initial value for the timer, it starts that counting process, but whenever timer reaches this maximum value, your flag bit is automatically becoming 1. So this flag bit you need to monitor from TCON register while doing programming. If it is 0, your timer is not reached maximum value. But whenever your timer is reached maximum value, this TF1 is becoming 1 automatically by reaching maximum value. So timer reaches maximum value and overwrites with 0 or overflows to 0. So after reaching maximum value, the timer next count is always 0. So in this state, whenever timer is changing from maximum value to 0 state, your flag bit is becoming 1. Otherwise, it keeps logic 0. No change from the flag bit logic. The next bit is TR1. So TR1 bit is helping us to start or stop the timer, like a control of times. So assigning logic 0, you are stopping the timer, and assigning logic 1, you are going to start the timer. But the TR1 is particularly working on timer 1. Okay, so TF1 and TR1. So these two bits are working on timer 1, and next TF0. So TF0 is also have the same description, but this TF0 is affected based on timer 0 selection. If you are looking to use timer 0 for applications, you need to monitor TF0 logic in programs. So this is 0 default, and whenever timer 0 overflows from maximum value to 0, then your TF0 becomes 1. So this is depends on the selection of timer, whether you are dealing with timer 0 or timer 1. The next bit is TR0. So this TR0 bit is helping us to start or stop timer 0. The logic of TR0 decides whether the timer 0 is in start state or stop state. The logic 0, stop timer 0, and logic 1, start timer 0. So this is the behavior of the 4 MSB bits of TCON register. So these 4 MSB bits, which is helps you to start the timers or monitor the cycles. So how many rotations you are doing with the timer, that you can take it count with the help of flag bit. For every one rotation, your flag bit is becoming 1. Again, you are looking for next repetition, you need to clear this flag bit and wait for next rotation completion. So this is how you need to deal with this TCON register bits, that is the 2 MSB part of TCON register. So these 4 bits, we discussed at interrupts feature, which are IE1, IT1, IE0, IT0. So this is going to deal with INT1 and INT0 interrupts. We will see at interrupts feature. But remember these 4 bits working. The first bit TF1 is used to whether the timer 1 is overflows from maximum value to 0 or not. And TR1 bit is helping us to start or stop timer 1. And TF0, which is helping us to see the status of timer 0. And TR0 bit is used to start or stop timer 0. And I'm going to explain the steps required to generate time delay by using timers. And you will write one example code. So these steps you need to follow in applications to generate accurate time delays using timers. Steps required to generate time delay. So the first step is choose the timer by using TMOD register, or select the timer by using TMOD. So TMOD register is always decides which timer in which mode. The second step is calculate initial values . So every timer is looking for accurate time delay. Depends on your required time delay, you need to know these initial values and assign these initial values to specific registers. So for timer 0, TH0, TL0. For timer 1, TH1 and TL1. So I am writing THX and TLX. Depends on your selection. If you are dealing with timer 0, use TL0 and TH0. If you are dealing with timer 1, use TL1 and TH1. And the third step is start timer. So which bit is helping us to start or stop the timer? From TCON register, there is a bit TR0 or TR1. And fourth step is wait for flag bit until it becomes 1. Wait until flag bit. So who is flag bit here? TF0 or TF1 according to your timer, or timer 0 or timer 1. Wait until flag bit becomes 1 or logic 1. Because the timer rotation or timer cycle, which is purely decided by flag bit logic. Fifth step is clear flag bit and repeat the process from step 2. Suppose you are looking for more cycles counting, like as per previous example, I am looking 57,593 pulses 8 times. So again you have to clear this flag bit and repeat your process from this step 2 if you have more pulses. And finally your pulses counting is over, stop time. So these are the 6 standard steps you need to follow for every time delay program by using timers. Now looking for 500 milliseconds time delay. So the same steps I will write in embedded C, you need to follow. So what are the steps? I am trying to include the header, standard header file for 51 families, which is reg51.h. Whenever I am including this, you are already aware the registers of microcontroller, you can directly use it in programs without any declaration. And then I will write main and anyway 500 milliseconds calculation is, the initial value is 7942 and counting up to 65,535, so that I am able to count 57,593 pulses, and this process I need to repeat 8 times. So this is my calculation. So looking for 8 times, I'll take one temporary variable which is V1. Now I am following as it is these steps. The first step is select the timer by using TMOD register. So I am directly giving TMOD register value is 0x10, so that what you are trying to take here, the value of TMOD 10H means timer 1 mode 1. So this is as per your table TMOD register hexa values. The second step is you need to take the initial values. Now my initial value is in 7942, but this is in decimal format. You need to convert into hexadecimal to assign your TH and TL resistors. So the conversion is 7942 hexadecimal conversion. I'll just go with 16 division process. 16 4 jar 64 154. Again 16 9 jar 144 10 102 16 6 jar 96 remainder is 6. And next 16 3 jar 48, 16 1 jar 16 remainder 0, and 16 1 jar 16 remainder 14. 14 means E means there is 15, which is F. So now my hexadecimal value is 1F06H. So from this entire hexadecimal value, the lower part is given to TL and higher part is given to TH. So which timer you selected? Timer 1. So the registers belongs to your timer 1 is TH1 and TL1. But you need to repeat this process 8 times. So I will take loop purpose for loop, which is V1, and repeating this process 8 times by using this for loop. What are your register values? TH1, which is 0x1F, and TL1, which is 06. This is my initial values of TH and TL registers. And third step is start timer. I am directly giving logic 1 for this TR1 bit. So TR1 bit from TCON register. And waiting for flag bit logic while TF1 equals to 0 with semicolon. So here the TF1, which is 0, still it will wait. So while, if you are terminating a statement with while with semicolon, the condition falls, then only it will go to the next line. So if it is true, it will stay here. So if TF0 is 0, then it doesn't go for next line. until unless
here
TF0 is becoming 1, then the compilation move to next. So TF0 is 0 here, it will wait. Whenever it is becoming 1, the time will, which is from 7942 to 65535, you just counted one time. But if you have to repeat this process 8 times, again by clearing your flag bit logic and again reassign the initial values for timer, which is 1F06, and keep timer on and wait for flag bit logic 1, and again clear it, and this process will repeat it 8 times. Once you are coming out of this for loop after completion of 8 times, stop the timer by giving your 0 bit logic 0 and end your main. This is your simple program to generate required time delay by using timers. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe the channel Heretic Solutions from YouTube.